Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. Friends, in this video we are going to discuss some important MCQs on higher education system for your upcoming Northeast set. And this is the syllabus for Northeast set. We have covered all the topics from higher education system. Then as you all know, we are providing you 40 mock tests for paper 1 where you will be prepared for 2000 MCQs here. And also we are providing you 1000 MCQs. Each unit carries 100 MCQs. Totally you will be prepared for 3000 MCQs here. This is enough preparation for your paper 1. I hope if you solve all these 3000 MCQs, you can score more than 70 in your paper 1. So you can focus more on your paper 2, and you can also download PDF with answers, all the mock tests and 1000 MCQs. Then notes we are providing on each unit, complete ebook we are providing with complete study material with the notes and also with the MCQs. This is available only at ₹599. To join this test, you can contact this number. The number is 8179138413. It is displayed on your screen. So let us move to the questions. And also friends, here once if you join for this Northeast set, you will be added to our paid WhatsApp group where you are getting the 40 mock test links, then 1000 MCQs, PDF and all. Let us move to the questions. Here the question is, a uniform civil code has been recommended in the directive principles to ensure option A, to control the population growth, option B, national security, option C, national integration, option D, support for weaker sections of society. Here the right answer is option C, national integration is the correct answer. And the uniform civil code, it is applicable to all religious communities in matters of divorce, marriage, adoption and inheritance. It will ensure national integration among the citizens. Please remember it. Let us move to the next question. Select the correct sequence in ascending order. Option A, deputy ministers. Option B, ministers of state. Option and cabinet ministers. Option B, ministers of state, deputy ministers and cabinet ministers. Option C, first ministers of state, then cabinet ministers and then deputy ministers. Option D, cabinet ministers, ministers of state, deputy ministers. Yes, here the correct sequence is option A, first comes deputy ministers, then ministers of state, then at the end cabinet ministers. Please remember this ascending order. Deputy ministers, minister of state and cabinet ministers. Option A is the correct sequence. The next question is, the Right to Education Act came into force in the year of option A 2008, option B 2009, option C 2010, option D none of the above. I hope all knew this answer. The right answer is option C 2010. Yes, Article 21A. Please remember this article. Article 21A of the Constitution of India provides free and compulsory education for all children age group between 6 to 14. It is a fundamental right, and Article 21A, the Right to Education Act, came into force on April 1st, 2020. Let us move to the next question. Which of the following is the lengthiest amendment to the Constitution of India so far? Option A, 24th Amendment. Option B, 30th Amendment. Option C, 42nd Amendment. Option D, 44th Amendment. Yes, the lengthiest amendment of the Constitution of India so far is 42nd Amendment. Next question. ODI has been assigned the status of classical language in February 2014. With this, the number of classical languages in India is total. How many classical languages are there now, including Odia? Option A, 4. Option A, 3. Option B, 4. Option C, 5. Option D, 6. Okay, now we are having 6 classical languages in India. Yes, the 8th schedule. Please remember, the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution lists 22 languages which have been referred as scheduled languages and given the recognition status and official encouragement. In addition to these 22 languages, the government of India, again, it has awarded 6 classical languages. Those are Kannada, Malayalam, Odia, Sanskrit, Tamil and Telugu. Yes, please remember, there are 6 classical languages are there, including Odia. So the next question is, which of the following introduced in Indian Penal Code? Option A, Lord Macaulay. Option B, Lord Dalhousie. Option C, Lord Curzon. Option D, Lord Ripon. Here the right answer is option A, Lord Macaulay. Yes, the next question is, which of the following pairs of articles of the Constitution of India and the subjects dealt with by them are correctly matched? First one, Article 352, Proclamation of Emergency. Second one, Article 370, Special Status in Respect of Jammu and Kashmir. Article 14, Equality of Opportunity in Matters of Public Employment. Article 40, Organization of Village Panchayats. Yes, you have to choose the correct codes given below. Here the right answer is option C, 1, 2 and 4. Article 352, Proclamation of Emergency. This is right. Article 370, Special Status in Respect of Jammu Kashmir. Yes, this is also correct. And fourth one, Article 40, Organization of Village Panchayat. But the third one, Article 14, Opportunity Matters of Public Employment. So no print, this is not the correct answer. Yes, the next question, the normal tenure of the governor of a state is option A, 5 years. Option B, till he or she enjoys the confidence of the president. Option C, till he or she enjoys the confidence of the chief minister. Option D, none of the above. Here the right answer is option A, 5 years. As the governor of a state, he is appointed by the president for the tenure of 5 years. And he holds office during his pleasure. As the next question, list 1 is showing article, list 2 is showing a subject. Article 54, 75, 155, 164. And subjects are president's election, prime minister's appointment, appointment of governor, appointment of chief minister. Here the right answer is option A is the correct answer. Article 54, it is related to president's election. Article 75 is related to prime minister appointment. Article 155 is related to appointment of governor. Article 164 is related to appointment of the chief minister. Yes, the next question is, which of the following age groups is taken into consideration for constituting gender parity index for higher education? 15 to 22, 18 to 23, 16 to 22, 18 to 25. Yes, here the right answer is option B, 18 to 23 years. Yes, gender parity index, which is known as the GPI. It is a socio-economic index. It is designed to measure the relative access to education of males and females. Please remember it. GPI is designed to measure the access to education of males and females. Yes, this index is released by UNESCO. Please remember this. A question may arise from here. GPI, gender parity index, is released by UNESCO. It is calculated as the quotient of the number of females by the number of males enrolled in a given stage of education. It may be in primary, in secondary or in higher education. And here please remember this information. If a GPI is equal to 1, signifies that equality between males and females. And if a GPI is less than 1, is an indication that gender parity favors males. And if the GPI is greater than 1, it indicates gender parity index that favors females. Please remember this information. Let us move to the next question. Equality of educational opportunities is possible by option A, extending portals of educational institutions to all without any discrimination. Option B, opening more educational institutions. Option C, privatizing the education system in the country. option D, public funding of education. Yes, here the right answer is option A. Equality of educational opportunities is possible by extending portals of educational institutions to all without any discrimination. Yes, let us go to the next question. 93rd Constitution Amendment Bill 6. Option A, to grant statehood to Uttaranchal. Option B, to make elementary education compulsory. Option C, to make army service mandatory. Option D, none of the above. Yes, here the right answer is to make elementary education compulsory. Yes, the main objective of 93rd Amendment Bill is to provide basic education to children in the age group of 0 to 6. Please remember 0 to 6 so that the government could escape from the constitutional responsibility. The next question, which of the following parts of the Indian Constitution enjoins upon the state to provide pre and compulsory education for children up to 14 years? Option A, directive principles of state policy. Option B, fundamental right. Option C, fundamental duties. Option C, special provisions related to certain classes. Yes, the right answer is directive principles of state policy. Yes, the next question, the directive principles. Option A, aim at establishing welfare state of Gandhian conception. Option B, aim at giving ideals to be incorporated at a later stage. Option C, aim at giving support to the fundamental rights. Option D, A and B only. Yes, here the right answer is option D, A and B. That is, aim to establish welfare state of Gandhian conception and aim to giving ideals to be incorporated at later stage. Both are correct, C is wrong. Directive principles of state policy aim to create social and economic conditions under the citizens can lead a good life. They also aim at establishing social and economic democracy in the economy. Yes, next, why are the fundamental rights considered fundamental? Option A, necessary for the successful working of democratic institution. Option B, basic to the welfare, dignity and happiness of the individual. Option C, constitution is based on these. Option D, only A and B. The right answer is option D, A and B, both are correct. That is, necessary for successful working of democratic institution and B, basic to the welfare, dignity and happiness of the individual. Both are correct. The next question, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha sit jointly when? Option A, they like. Option B, there is disagreement between the two. Option C, the president summons both the houses. Option D, they must meet when 2 years have lapsed after the last meeting. Yes, the right answer is option B. The Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha sit jointly when there is a disagreement between the two houses. Yes, friend, this is about our today's session. Once again, I would like to remind you about our Northeast set test series where we are providing you 40 tests. You will be prepared for 2000 MCQs ARE. We are including the questions from each unit. Okay, then we are providing you 1000 MCQs. Totally, you will be prepared for 3000 MCQs here. You can also download the PDF. We are also providing the e-book with notes and with MCQs. All these are available only at ₹599. For this, you can contact to the given number. Yes, thank you. And also, you can download our Global Online University app and you can select Northeast category. Yes, thank you very much. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos on UGC NET, KSA and other set examination for mock tests and for MCQs, you can subscribe to Global Online University YouTube channel. Thank you.